Welcome, this will be a quick video. Now that we have created the report controller, let's create a route and a menu link to it. Then we will view it on our site. Code editor activate. Stellar. First, open the routing file of rsvplist.routing.yaml and enter the following route. Keep in place any existing routes. As you can see, we are routing to a controller this time. The class this route invokes is the report controller, and the method is the report method. Notice that the permission is the custom access RSVP list report permission we created earlier. Be sure to double check your code and then save the file. Amazing! Let's create a menu link for this route. Open the rsvplist.links.menu.yaml file to add another link to it. Below the admin settings link, place the code for the link to the RSVP report page. The format of this link should be familiar by now. Note that the parent route of system.admin_reports corresponds to the URL path of /admin/reports. Double check your code and save the file. Awesome! Now, head over to your site so we can see the RSVP report in action. Trying out new functionality is fun. First, be sure to flush the cache. Nice. Next, head over to the report section by clicking on Reports in the admin menu. On this page, we see the list of reports we have access to. Accounts which do not have the permission called Access RSVP List Report will not see the report listed here. Good to know. Before I click on the link for the list of RSVP submissions, as a mental note, I am anticipating seeing a table with no RSVP submissions. That's because I recently uninstalled and then reinstalled the RSVP list module, removing all that data. Okay, clicking on the RSVP submissions link. Awesome! I see the HTML table for the RSVP submissions. As expected, it is empty, displaying the default text of no entries available. No biggie. Let's head over to an event to add some distinguished guests and get this event started. First, I need to recall what event types I had declared to be events. So I'll head over to configuration, content authoring, RSVP list settings. Nice, it looks like articles are certainly selected, so I'll head over to an article. Clicking on the content to see what's available. Next, I'll click on the welcome article. I'll add a couple of emails, including the previously entered example at example.com, RSVP, and famousperson1@example.com, RSVP. Great! After making sure that some RSVPs have been indicated, I'll head back over to the list of RSVP submissions. Visit Reports, click on the list. Yeah! As we can see, our event is getting hot! Already, we have two RSVPs. Ooh! I wonder who famous person one is. Super effort from you in developing a controller which displays a list of RSVPs. In coming videos, we will alter the node edit forms for indicated RSVP content types, and eventually we will build our own custom service. Nice work and happy learning.